Now let us see how to convert an epsilon NFA to NFA. Epsilon NFA means the NFA with the epsilon transition. So if you want to convert an epsilon NFA to NFA, then first of all you are going to need to know that what is the epsilon closure, and then we are going to use that epsilon closure to convert the epsilon NFA to NFA. So I have written a simple algorithm, or you can say simple procedure, to convert an epsilon NFA to NFA, and after converting that NFA we can convert it to DFA. The procedure will be, we have an NFA with epsilon move, then we convert with the epsilon NFA with epsilon move to without epsilon move, and then we convert this to DFA. So what is the procedure? First of all, find out all the epsilon transition from each state from Q that will be called as epsilon closure. That means for every state, find an epsilon closure. Then delta dash transition can be obtained, and epsilon dash transition means that epsilon closure on epsilon delta, that we will see. Then step 2 is repeated for each input symbol and for each state of a given epsilon NFA. Now using that resultant state transition table for equivalent NFA without epsilon can be built. So let me explain you. I know that it is very difficult to understand, but let me explain you. Assume we have this following epsilon NFA. This is the state Q naught. This is the transition on simple A. This is an epsilon move. This is the state Q1. This is a transition on B. This is an epsilon move. Then this is the state which is Q2. This is a transition on C. A, B, and C. Now we want to convert the following NFA with epsilon move to epsilon NFA. Then first of all, the first step is, for every symbol find the epsilon closure. We have three symbols here, A, B, and C, because this particular NFA is built on three symbols, the language is containing three symbols which are A, B, and C. So first of all, let us find the epsilon closure on every particular input. If for example you are at state Q naught, then we will find epsilon closure. This is denoting epsilon closure, and then we will see what are the states we can go after seeing the A symbol, and then we will see what are the states we can go after that. See, why I'm taking epsilon closure two times, generally when if you know regular expression that I will be teaching at a later point of time, in case of regular expression, if we say that epsilon dot A, then it is equal to A dot epsilon, which is equal to epsilon dot A dot epsilon, and all these are actually equivalent to A. So that epsilon, we can concatenate epsilon with any particular symbol, and still we are going to get that symbol only. So that is why, if with symbol A initially we can have any number of epsilons, after that we can have any number of epsilons. So we know that if I'm going to make a transition for epsilon closure first, then I'll make a transition for A, and then I will make transition for epsilon again. Right, so that is why we are going to find epsilon closure, then transition of that particular symbol, and then epsilon closure again. So for the state Q naught, what is the epsilon closure? The state for Q naught, the epsilon closure is Q naught, Q1, and Q2. That means just by seeing an epsilon symbol, what are the states you can go? So from Q naught, we can go to Q naught itself, we can go to Q1, as well as we can go to Q2. Now if we are at Q naught and there is a symbol A, then we are again going to Q naught. So there is a symbol A, again we are going to Q naught. And then if we are at Q1, by seeing a symbol A, we are not going anywhere. That means there is no transition which is defined for the symbol A. That means we are not going to any state which is phi. In the same way, if we are at state Q2, by seeing a symbol A, we are not going anywhere because there is no transition which is defined for symbol A. Therefore, we are again going to phi. Again, here we have only one state which is Q0. So, if you are at state Q0, just by seeing an epsilon symbol, we can go to state Q0, Q1, and Q2. So, we can go to state Q0, Q1, and Q2. Okay, this is for the symbol A. Now do the same thing for symbol B as well as for symbol C. Okay, this is for symbol B. This is epsilon closure. This is epsilon closure. So if you're at Q0 state, then just by seeing epsilon, you can go to state Q0, you can go to state Q1, you can go to state Q2. If you're at state Q0, by seeing B, you're not going anywhere. If you're at state Q1, by seeing B, you are again going to Q1. If you're at state Q2, by seeing B, you're not going anywhere. And then the epsilon closure of Q1 is Q1 and Q2. It is Q1 and Q2. Okay, now let us find the same for the symbol C. This is C, epsilon closure, and then this is Q0. Okay, so I know that if you are at state C, just by seeing epsilon symbol, you are only going to state C itself. If you are at state Q0, just by seeing an epsilon symbol, you are going to state Q0, you are going to state Q1, as well as you are going to state Q2. Now, on Q0, if you see a symbol C, then you are not going anywhere. On Q1, if you see a symbol C, then you are not going anywhere. If you are at Q2, on seeing a symbol C, you are again going to Q2. Okay, now the epsilon closure again. So epsilon closure of Q2 is only Q2. So this is for the state which is Q0. Find the same things for the state Q1 as well as for the state Q2. So let us do it. This is epsilon closure. This is A. This is epsilon closure. And this is Q2. If you take the closure of, for Q1, let us find for Q1, then we'll find for Q2. If you are at state Q2, just by seeing an epsilon, you can go to Q2 as well as you can go to Q1. So you can go to Q1 as well as you can go to Q2. If you are at Q1, just by seeing a symbol A, you are not going anywhere. And by seeing a symbol A on Q2, you are not going anywhere. Therefore, epsilon closure will be 5. Now, again, find for B, epsilon closure. If you are at state Q2, by seeing the epsilon closure, if you are at state Q2, sorry, it is Q1, not Q2. If you are at state Q1, by seeing epsilon, you can go to Q2 as well as you can go to Q1. So you can go to Q1 as well as you can go to Q2. Then if you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol B, you can go to Q1 itself. If you are at Q2, by seeing a symbol B, you cannot go anywhere. Now, epsilon closure of Q1 is Q1 as well as Q2. Now, find the same for C, the symbol C. It is epsilon closure, and this is Q1. So, epsilon closure of Q1 is Q1 and Q2. If you see a symbol C on Q1, then you are not going anywhere. If you see a symbol C on Q2, then you are going to Q2 itself. And then epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2 itself. Right. Now, make the same table for Q2. This is epsilon closure. This is symbol A. This is epsilon closure. And this is Q2. On Q2, the epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2 itself. Then, if you see a symbol A on Q2, then you are not going anywhere, and then it is 5. Again, on seeing a symbol B, for epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2. By seeing a symbol B, you are not going anywhere, so it is 5. If you are at Q2, by seeing a symbol C, so epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2. By seeing a symbol C, you are going to Q2, and the epsilon closure of Q2 is again Q2. So we got this one. Now, after getting these tables, we can make a straight transition diagram of the NFA. Now, let us make the straight transition diagram. I don't have enough space, so I'm writing here. So it is representing, if you are getting symbol A, symbol B, and symbol C, if you are at state Q0, you are at state Q1, you are at state Q2, and this is the initial state, and Q2 was the final state. Q2 is the final state. Okay, now you can see on Q0, by seeing a symbol A, we go to Q0, Q1 and Q2. So we are going to Q0, Q1 and Q2. That means these three states. On Q0, by seeing a symbol B, we are going to Q1 and Q2. We are going to Q1 and Q2. On Q0, by seeing a symbol C, we are only going to Q2. If you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol A, you are going to phi. If you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol B, you are going to Q1 and Q2. If you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol C, you are going to Q2. Now, if you are at Q2, by seeing a symbol A, you are going to phi. If you are at Q2, by seeing a symbol B, you are going to phi. If you are at Q2, by seeing a symbol C, you are going to Q2. You are going to Q2. Okay. Now, this is a final state transition table for the NFA. So, we converted an epsilon NFA to NFA, and now we can convert this particular NFA to DFA. So, by seeing this, you can easily make out the states. I don't have enough space here. Let me write it here. So, we have, by seeing this, let me draw it. If you are at state Q0, second state is Q1, and third state is Q2, and Q2 is a final state. So, it is saying, if you are at Q0, by seeing a symbol A, you can go to Q0, Q1, and Q2. You can go to Q0, Q1, and Q2. Again, if you are at Q0, by seeing a symbol B, you can go to Q1 and Q2. By seeing a symbol B, you can go to Q1 as well as Q2. Right? If you are at Q0, by seeing a symbol C, you are going to Q2. If you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol A, you are not making any transition. If you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol B, you are making a transition to Q1 as well as Q2. If you are at Q1, by seeing a symbol C, you are making a transition to Q2 itself. If you are at Q2, by seeing a symbol C, you can make a transition for Q2. So this is an NFA which is equivalent to this epsilon NFA. Now you can convert this NFA to a DFA, and that I told you that we have done in the previous videos, that is a very simple process. Okay, so now let us move on to the next section.